Good morning class. Today we are going to do our first chapter of class 9, which is number system. But before starting, just take a quick recap of whatever concept we already done in the previous class. The first is, what do you mean by a natural number? So natural numbers, jinhe hum counting numbers bhi kehte hain, aur wo numbers ka set jo ki 1 se shuru hota hai, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. जब हम नेचुरल नंबर्स के सेट में ज़ीरो को ऐड कर देते हैं तो जो हमें नया कलेक्शन मिलता है दैट न्यू कलेक्शन ऑफ द नंबर्स दिस इज़ नोन एज होल नंबर. सो होल नंबर्स आर दोज नंबर विच स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ज़ीरो. सो ज़ीरो, वन, टू, थ्री, फोर. तो जितने भी नेचुरल नंबर्स हैं दे आर ऑलरेडी इंक्लूडेड इन होल नंबर. सो वी कैन से डैट एवरी नेचुरल नंबर इज़ ऑल्सो अ होल नंबर. बट एवरी होल नंबर इज़ नॉट अ नेचुरल नंबर बिकॉज ज़ीरो होल नंबर है बट ज़ीरो इज़ नॉट अ नेचुरल नंबर. सो नाउ if we add the negative numbers means minus 2, minus 4, minus 3 and so on. If we add all those numbers to the set of whole numbers, then the new collection which we get is known as integers. So integers are 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, all those numbers, they will form the set of collection, and this set of collection is known as integers. Now today we are going to talk about rational numbers. Rational numbers are those numbers which can be written in the form of p by q, where q is not equal to 0. आपने अक्सर ऐसे numbers देखे होंगे जिनको हम 1 upon 2, 3 upon 2 इस type के numbers. So in all these number there is a symbol जिसके ऊपर और नीचे दो numbers लिखे होते हैं. ऊपर वाला number and नीचे वाला the number which is written above this line, this is known as numerator, and the number which is written below this line is known as denominator. So agar kisi bhi number ko aap is form mein dekhe, p by q ki form mein, jisme niche ka denominator, the number which is written below this line, this number is not equal to 0, then those types of number are known as natural numbers. Aur is type ke numbers ke collection ko hum kehte hain रैशनल नंबर्स. और इसको रिप्रेजेंट करने के लिए हम जिस सिंबल का यूज़ करते हैं डैट सिंबल इज़ क्यू. सो क्यू इज़ नथिंग बट द सेट ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स, एंड रैशनल नंबर्स आर दोज नंबर्स विच कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी बाई क्यू, वेयर क्यू इज़ नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, एंड पी एंड क्यू आर इंटीजर्स. मीन्स द नंबर विच इज़ रिटन अबव द लाइन एंड बिलो द लाइन कैन बी नेगेटिव एज वेल एज पॉजिटिव. नाउ क्वेश्चन, सो नाउ क्वेश्चन अराइजेज वेदर एवरी नेचुरल नंबर इज अ रैशनल नंबर, एंड द आंसर इज येस. How we can prove it? Just look at this example. Like we have a natural number, just take as 2. So 2 can be written as 2 upon 1. आपको शायद याद होगा वो number जिसके नीचे आपको denominator में कुछ भी visible नहीं होता. This one is known as, हम इसे कहते हैं visible math, invisible math. Invisible math जो हमें दिखाई नहीं देता पर होता है. सो एवरी नंबर, कोई भी नेचुरल नंबर ले लें या कोई भी रैशनल होल नंबर लें या फिर कोई भी इंटीजर लें, उसके नीचे डिनोमिनेटर में आपको कोई नंबर दिखाई नहीं देता बट वो होता है, डैट इज़ इनविजिबल मैथ. सो 2 को हम 2 अपॉन 1 लिख सकते हैं, सिमिलरली 3 को हम 3 अपॉन 1 लिख सकते हैं, माइनस 3 को माइनस 3 अपॉन 1 के फॉर्म में रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं. तो इस तरीके से सारे नेचुरल नंबर्स, सारे होल नंबर्स एंड इंटीजर्स को हम पी अपॉन क्यू की फॉर्म में रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं. और क्योंकि ये सारे नेचुरल नंबर, होल नंबर एंड इंटीजर्स इस फॉर्म में रिप्रेजेंट हो रहे हैं, डैट मींस दे आर आल्सो रैशनल नंबर्स. यही चीज़ बताने के लिए यहाँ पे एक डायग्राम बनाया गया है. दैट डायग्राम शोज दैट द स्मॉलेस्ट कलेक्शन ऑफ नंबर इज अवर नेचुरल नंबर, एंड व्हेन वी ऐड जीरो टू दिस कलेक्शन देन वी गेट द नेक्स्ट कलेक्शन विच इज़ नोन एज होल नंबर. सो इट इज़ बिगर देन natural number. Now we are adding the negative integers to the whole numbers, negative numbers to the whole number. So the next collection which is bigger than this two set of collection is our integers, and the among the four the biggest one is our rational numbers, because all these collections are already there in the rational numbers. So rational number is the biggest collection of set among these four collection of sets. So we can say that every natural number is a rational number, every whole number is also a rational number, and every integer is a rational number. So rational numbers ke paas extra numbers hain. Already rational numbers ke andar natural number bhi aate hain, whole numbers bhi aate hain, integers bhi aate hain. Uske alawa bhi kuch aise numbers hain jo ki पी अपॉन क्यू की फॉर्म में रिप्रेजेंट होते हैं वो सारे भी रैशनल नंबर्स के आते हैं, अंदर आते हैं, बट वो इन सब के कलेक्शन में नहीं आते. सो आवर रैशनल नंबर्स का कलेक्शन इज द बिगेस्ट कलेक्शन अमंग दीज फोर कलेक्शंस ऑफ नंबर. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू, सो नाउ आवर टास्क इज टू फाइंड फाइव रैशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन एनी टू गिवन नंबर. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन विच यू विल see in your exam, that find five rational numbers between minus 2 and 6. So it is obvious that minus 2 and 6 ke beech mein already five rational numbers hain, more than 5 hain. Like minus 2 aur 6 ke beech mein kaun kaun se rational numbers hain? Minus 1, then 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they are already already more than 5. So just write any five numbers and your answer is complete. In the second question, in the second type of question, you have to find five rational numbers between 1 and 2. Since between 1 and 2, it is not easy to find the rational number. So in this question, you have to find out the equivalent fraction of 1 and 2. So finding equivalent fraction means multiplying both these numbers by some number. So which number I am going to multiply? This is decided by how many rational numbers we are going to find. Suppose we have to find 5 rational numbers, so we are going to multiply it by any number which is greater than 5. If we want to find 4 rational number, then we will multiply it by any number which is greater than 4. So now we have to find 5 rational numbers, so I am going to multiply it by 6. As I have already told you that 1 can be written as 1 upon 1, so I am multiplying 1 by 6. So multiplying 1 by 6 means you have to multiply denominator as well as numerator. So I am multiplying denominator and numerator by 6. So 1 is equal to 6 upon 6, and by multiplying 2 by 6 we get 2 is equal to 12 by 6. Again here 2 can be written as 2 upon 1, and I am multiplying it by 6 means multiplying the denominator as well as the numerator. So by multiplying we get 2 is equal to 12 upon 6. So we are getting two equivalent fractions of 1 and 2, and now we are going to find out five rational number between these two equivalent fractions. Finding rational numbers between equivalent fractions is same as finding the rational numbers between the numbers. So the numbers which are between 6 by 6 and 12 by 6 are 7 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, 10 by 6 and 11 by 6. So you will get exactly 5 rational numbers. If you multiply it by any number, by any other number like 7, 8 or 9, so you will get more than 5 rational numbers. So for getting 5 rational number, you have to multiply it by 6, or if you want to find out more rational number, then you have to multiply it by some number which is bigger than 6. So hence the 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2 are 7 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, 10 by 6 and 11 by 6. Now this is the second type of. Now we already done two types of question which were asked in your exam. Now we are going to do another type of question which is asked in your exam. This is the question of finding rational numbers between minus 2 by 3 and 1 by 4. So here already a rational number is given. In the previous one, you had some integers, and now we are finding rational numbers between rational numbers. So these are rational numbers, and just look here, their denominator is different. So the first task is to make their denominator same. So how you are going to make their denominator same? By finding their LCM, or you can just simply multiply 3 by 4 and 4 by 3. Since here the LCM of 3 and 4 is 12, so we are going to multiply this and this number by this number by 4 and this number by 3, and after multiplying it we get their equivalent fraction. So this is again a process of getting equivalent fraction. So here we are going to find out rational numbers between the equivalent fractions of two given numbers. So now the first number is minus 2 by 3. So by multiplying it by 4, again I am repeating, we have to multiply the numerator as well as the denominator. So minus 2 multiplied by 4 and 3 multiplied by 4. Minus 2 multiplied by 4 is minus 8, and 3 multiplied by 4 is 12. So minus 8 by 12 is an equivalent fraction of minus 2 by 3. Now we are going to multiply 1 by 4 by 3, because in the denominator we have to make 12. Here also we have to make 12. So how how by which number you are going to multiply 3, so you will get 12. So we have to multiply 3 by 4 and multiply 4 by 3 in order to get 12. So here we are going to multiply it by 3. So by multiplying by 3 we get 3 by 12. So now we are going to find 5 rational number between minus 8 by 12 and 3 by 12. So 5 rational numbers between minus 8 by 12 and 3 by 12 are minus 7 by 12, minus 6 by 12, minus 5 by 12, minus 4 by 12 and minus 3 by 12. So these are also the rational numbers between minus 2 by 3 and 1 by 4. So in all these questions you see that if you are able to find out the rational numbers directly, then just write it there. And if you are not able to find out it directly, then you have to find out their equivalent fraction. And by finding the rational numbers between their equivalent fraction, you can find out the any numbers of rational numbers between the given numbers. So now you have to complete your exercise 1.1. I am just discussing here. The first question says, is 0 a rational number? Then, is 0 a rational number? Yes, it is a rational number. Why? Because 0 can be written as 0 upon 1. Or you can write 0 in any way. You can write 0 as 0 by 2, 0 by 3. 0 upon any number other than 0 is a rational number. So 0 is definitely a rational number which can be written in the form of p by q. You can write 0 as 0 by 1 or 0 by 2 or 0 by 3. All these numbers are equal to 0 except 0 by 0, because 0 by 0 is not defined. So here, is 0 a rational number? Yes, 0 is a rational number. Yes, we can write it in the form of p by q. Now you have to find 5 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Already we have done the process of how you will going to find 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2. Here you have to find 5 rational numbers between 3 and 4. So I think you can do it. Now in the third question, you have to find 5 rational numbers between 3 by 4 and 4 by 5. Here the denominator is already equal, so you have to just multiply it by 6, and by finding their equivalent fraction you can easily find out 5 rational numbers between them. Now in the question number 4, he says that state whether the following statements are true and false and give reasons for your answer. So first statement is, every natural number is a whole number. Yes, every natural number is a whole number, because natural number starts from 1 and whole number starts from 0. So every natural number is already included in whole number. Now every integer is a whole number. This is not correct. Why? Because every integers means positive number as well as negative numbers. Positive numbers are already there in whole number, because whole number start from 0, 1, 2 and so on. But negative numbers are not there, so every integer is not a whole number. But you can say every whole number is a integer. Now every rational number is a whole number. This statement is again false, because just take any example, just take any rational number. Suppose we are taking 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is a rational number, but 1 by 2 is not a whole number, because whole numbers are those numbers which starts from 0. 0, 1, 2, all these types of numbers are whole number, and 1 by 2 is a rational number which is not a whole number. Similarly, you can find more examples for proving this statement. So every rational number is not a whole number. This statement is false.